Gauranga, Nitai Gauranga, Nitai Gauranga, Jai Gaura Hari, Gaura 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 Hari, Gaura 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 Hari, Jai Gaura Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Nitai Gaura Hari Bol, Jai Sachinandana, Jai Sachinandana, Jai Sachinandana, Gaura Hari, Jai Sachinandana, Jai Sachinandana, Jai Sachinandana, Gaura Hari, Gaura 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 Hari, Gaura 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 Hari, Nitai Gaura Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Nitai Gaura Hari Bol, Jai Prabhupada, Jai Prabhupada, Jai Prabhupada, Jai Prabhupada, Jai Jai Prabhupada, 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 Jai Jai Prabhupada. विष्णुपाद परमहंस परवराज का आचार्य अष्टोत्तर सत श्रीमद विदेशी भक्त वेदांत स्वामी प्रभुपाद की जय। एवं विष्णुपाद परमहंस परवराज का आचार्य अष्टोत्तर सत श्रीमद विदेशी भक्त सिद्धांत सरस्वती ठाकुर गोस्वामी प्रभुपाद की जय। अनंत कोटि वैष्णव की जय। नमाचार्य हरदास ठाकुर की जय। प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गधाधार श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त जय। श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गोप गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरि गोवर्धन की जय। ब्रजभूमि श्री वृंदावन धाम की जय। नवद्वीप मायापुर धाम की जय। श्रीक्षेत्र जगन्नाथपुरी धाम की जय। गंगमय यमुनामय की जय। भक्ति देवी तुलसी महारानी की जय। समवेत भक्त वृंद की जय। हरिनाम संकीर्तन की जय। नितय गो प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि भो। ऑल ओरिस्ट टू असेंबली बॉडीज, ऑल ओरिस्ट टू असेंबली बॉडीज, ऑल ओरिस्ट टू असेंबली बॉडीज, ऑल ओरिस्ट, ऑल ओरिस्ट, ऑल ओरिस्ट, ऑल श्री गुरु एंड गौरांग शुभपाद की जय। ओम विष्णु बधाए कृष्ण पेष्टाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी नाम नमस्ते सारस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारण्य विशेष शून्यवाद पंचाच देस्तारण कृष्णा वी आर रीडिंग फ्रॉम भगवद्गीता चैप्टर टू कंटेंट्स ऑफ गीता समराइज वर्स नंबर 71 72 लास्ट वर्सेस। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयत् नष्टाप्रायेषु भद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया। भगवती उत्तम श्लोके भक्ति भवति नैष्ठिकि। ओम तत्सत्। 2.71 विहाय कामान्य सर्वान् पुमां चरति निःस्पृहः निर्ममो निरहंकारः स शान्तिम् अधिगच्छति। विहाय कामान् यः सर्वान् पुमां चरति निःस्पृहः निर्ममो निरहंकारः स शान्तिम् अधिगच्छति। विहाय कामान् यः सर्वान् पुमां चरति निःस्पृहः निर्ममो निरहंकार स शांतिम अधिगच्छति। विहाय गिविंग अप कामान मटेरियल डिजायर्स फॉर सेंस ग्रेटिफिकेशन या हु सर्वान ऑल पुमान ए पर्सन चरति लिव्स निस्पृहः डिजायरलेस निर्मम विदाउट सेंस ऑफ प्रोप्राइटरशिप निरहंकार विदाउट फॉल्स ईगो स ही शांतिम परफेक्ट पीस अधिगच्छति अटेन्स। ट्रांसलेशन भक्त वेदांत पर्सन हु हैज गिवन अप ऑल डिजायर्स फॉर सेंस ग्रेटिफिकेशन हु लिव्स फ्री फ्रॉम डिजायर हु हैज गिवन अप ऑल सेंस ऑफ प्रोप्राइटरशिप एंड इज डिवाइड ऑफ ऑल ईगो ही अलोन कैन अटेन रियल पीस। Repeat. A person who has given up all desires for sense gratification, who lives free from desires, who has given up all sense of proprietorship and is devoid of false ego, he alone can attain real peace. Verse number 72. येषा ब्राह्मे स्थितः पार्था नैनं प्राप्त्या विमोह्यति स्थित्वा स्यामन्तकालेऽपि ब्रह्मनिर्वाणम् रुच्यति। येषा ब्राह्मे स्थितः पार्था नैनां प्राप्त्या विमोह्यति स्थित्वा स्यामन्तकालेऽपि ब्रह्मनिर्वाणम् रुच्यति। एषा ब्राह्मी स्थिति पार्थ नैनं प्राप्याभिमुह्यति स्थित्वा स्यामन्त कालेपि ब्रह्म निर्वाण पृच्छति। एषा ब्राह्मी स्थिति पार्थ नैनं प्राप्याभिमुह्यति स्थित्वा स्यामन्त कालेपि ब्रह्म निर्वाणम् रुच्यति। सिनोनिम्स एषा दिस ब्राह्मी स्पिरिचुअल स्थिति सिचुएशन पार्था ओ सनापृथा नॉन एवर एनाम दिस प्राप्य अचीविंग विमोहयति वन इज बिविल्डर्ड स्थित्वा बीइंग सिचुएटेड अस्याम इन दिस अंतकाले एट द एंड ऑफ लाइफ अपि आल्सो ब्रह्म निर्वाण द स्पिरिचुअल किंगडम ऑफ गॉड रुच्यति वन अटेन्स। ट्रांसलेशन दैट इज द वे ऑफ स्पिरिचुअल एंड गॉडली लाइफ आफ्टर अटेनिंग व्हिच ए मैन इज नॉट बिविल्डर्ड इफ वन इज द सिचुएटेड इवन एट द आवर ऑफ डेथ वन कैन एंटर इनटू किंगडम ऑफ गॉड। That is the way of spiritual and godly life, after attaining which a man is not bewildered. If one is thus situated even at the hour of death, one can enter into the kingdom of God. Okay. We'll try to understand this verse. Om Ajnanati Mirandasya Gnananjana Salakaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंगेते गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वंदे श्रीगुरुं दीनतारिणं परमानन्दमाधवं श्रीचैतन्यविश्वं वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधार श्रीवासादि गौरभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपः कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वापदान्तिकं। रूप गोस्वामी प्रभुपाद की जय। श्री प्रभुपाद की जय। गौर भक्त मंत्र की जय। सो टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग द लास्ट टू वर्सेस ऑफ दिस चैप्टर भगवद्गीता Hundreds of Gita summarized. So basically this is in the last section, sixth section of Bhagavad Gita, where Krishna is talking about the answering, replying to the question, Arjuna's question, first question, where how does a self-realized soul behave? How does he sit? How does he walk? How does he act or speak? So, kim prabhasit, kim asit, kim vrajet, kim. So, 2.54. Then Lord Krishna started replying. So, basically, he has divided how living and how the practitioner, especially those who are fixed up, one who is already situated in transcendence, is how his mind works, how his mind is dedicated, always thinking about the Supreme Lord. And then he talked about how his senses, because senses are, above the senses are the mind, so how his senses are always serving the Supreme Lord, using or attracted toward the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord, attracted toward the holy name of the Lord, attracted to the qualities of the divine qualities of the Supreme Lord, attracted towards the divine pastimes of the Supreme Lord. So the and then Krishna is talking about how the transcendentalist, the self-realized soul is situated, how his intelligence is always sharpened by sadhu and shastra and guru, especially shastra, weapons, shastra, is completely controlled. His intelligence is completely sharpened, controlled, purified by the weapon. So, dhanudhyasina yukta karma granthi nibandham. Without a sword of transcendental knowledge, there is no way to cut the heavy knots, the hard knots in the heart and all the senses. So that the self-realized soul is always being sharpening his intelligence, always guided, following every day from the Shastra and Sadhu and Guru. Shastra through Sadhu, not only other than self-reading, hearing from Sadhu. Then Krishna is talking about the last section, last few verses from all the way from 68, I think. 69 onward. He's talking about the desires. Indirectly, he's talking about the false ego. So, how the practice self-realized soul is fixed up. His ego, his real ego, is operating with the real ego. That means he's thinking that, what is that? Tad vritya vritya paricharaka vritya vritya vrityasya vrityasya iti mam smaralokanada. I'm your servant. King Kulashekara is praying. So, even Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also showing that example. So, always we are the servant of the Supreme Lord. Servant of our natural position, Jivir Sarupe Nityar Krishna Das. That is our identity, actual identity. Original identity, real identity is servant of Krishna. So, that's why so the self-realized soul is acting on that platform. The real ego, the servant of Krishna, servant of his spiritual master, not the servant of the senses, not the servant of the material desires. That's what we discussed in great detail, and how Hanuman, Lord Hanuman, has passed through the various obstacles of Mainaka, Surasa and Simhika in terms of his various obstacles in the path of journey to achieve the to reach the ultimate goal. And it's very difficult. Now this verse, last few, two verses is concluding. That's why it is mentioned, the Esha Brahmi Stata Parda Nainam Prahya Nainam Prahya Vivam Yati Stitvasya Antakale Brahma Nirvana Ruchat. So, Prabhupada emphasizes, and then Krishna speaking here, basically, one who is situated like this, his mind, his senses, his intelligence, his ego is always thinking how to serve the Supreme Lord Sri Krishna, how to serve the spiritual master. All his body, everything, gross body, subtle body, everything is operating under this, completely dedicated in this way. Then automatically at any time, even while he is on this material world, he is operating on the spiritual, operating on the Brahma Bhuta platform. Because the actual devotion service starts from this point, Brahma Bhuta platform. Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma Na Sochati Na Kaanksha Samas Sarveshu Bhuteshu Mad Bhaktim Labate Param. That Param means Transcendental Personality of Godhead. Because he is attained, it is enlivening. Because he is having a pleasure, so much unlimited pleasure, as we discussed last week also. Anandambudhi Vardhanam, not Nirananda Vardhanam. Because it is increasing, ever increasing. And Lord Krishna is giving the example, I think, Prabuddha, king, speaking to King Nimi, now Yogendra speaking, Bhakti Pareshana Bhava Viraktra Anyatra Syat Etasmita Asyu Trish Eka Kala, where it is mentioned, compared with when a person is hungry, so is Bhakti Pareshana Bhava. First one is Bhakti devotion service and Virakti Pareshana Bhava. So we will get the realizations. Paresha Anubhava, direct realization, practical realizations, while executing devotion, and then automatically also detachment will happen. These three things, while practicing devotion service, while engaging in devotion, is getting realization, at the same time is getting internal detachment from all the things. these three things are just like the person who is eating, the one who is given the food, then automatically what? His hunger, his thirst is already gone and no more. He is completely satiated. So, and he is fully happy. So, no more. His hunger already gone through and he is fully happy with him because he is pleased by taking all his senses or received that energy while taking, and then no more. He is completely eradicated. No more hunger is there. No more. He is, even somebody brings food, then he will not take because he is completely full. So in this way, the bhakti, by performing devotion service, then automatically and will try to understand from as we are going through the now Lord Jagannath Snan Yatra. Now Radha Yatra is coming up on July 11th, actual day, very, very auspicious day. And day before is the Gundicha Marjam, Gundicha Yatra. Because that is the day, Gundicha Marjam, that is the day actually Navayavana Vesh happens, Netrotso happens that day. After the Anavasar period of almost 2 weeks. So day before Radha Yatra is the day, first day, Lord Jagannath gives his darshan. So beautiful Vesh after, because here generally means other time in Jagannath Puri, Lord Jagannath gets repainted during these 2 weeks. That is so many different reasons are there. So it's not a, means it's a very confidential and it's very deep subject matter. So all these pastimes, especially Lord Jagannath's pastime of this taking on to the Radha Yatra, actually just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, non-different actually. Navadvip Dham is non-different from Vrindavan and Jagannath, and Navadvip Dham and Jagannath Puri and Vrindavan, these three are non-different actually. So same, including Jagannath Puri, all Aishwarya, Aurya, Madhurya, everything is there in Jagannath Puri. So same, whatever Lord Jagannath is going through, that separation from Srimad Radharani, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is going through the separation from Krishna, because he has, Sri Krishna has, he is in the mood of Srimad Radharani. The opposite is happening. Radha Viraha Vidura, and then Lord Jagannath is called Krishna Viraha Vidura. So, or the other way. Yeah, Krishna Viraha Vidura. He is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Radha Viraha Vidura is Lord Jagannath. In this way, both are operating at that mood of separation, love and separation. So, that is happening. That's why Lord is going from Nilachal to Sundarachal, from Madhuri Dham to Dwaraka, as a prince, as a king. So much opulence is in Jagannath Puri. And we will go through the example how the great devotees, the example from these pastimes, these two verses as it is mentioned, how will we become Nirmama, Nirahankara, Vihaya Sarvan F Kaman, all the desire, how will we become desireless? How will we be able to give up desires? We cannot become desireless, but we become actually desire to use everything in the service of Krishna. So how will we be able to get? And one instruction, as we can see here also, the last point, Prabhupada also mentions, even Katvanga Maharaj is able to do in 1 minute, as soon as he got to know, when he went and fought with demigods, because he was so valiant king, demigods called him to to fight for them. Then he fought, and then they won. Now they are... So now your time is of what boon you want. Then he said, no, I want to know how much time I have left in my life. He said, only 1 minute. So immediately he decided, okay, he thought about the Supreme Lord and then he went back to Godhead. So this is the example Prabhupada is giving. What does that mean? That means surrendering, completely surrender. So anybody can surrender at any time. It doesn't matter. So he can go back. It's not a complicated subject, it's not a complex thing, but the problem is we are operating differently. We are operating under the mind and senses, intelligence, desires and ego, false ego. Everything is under the material conception. So that's where the biggest problem is. So that's why the one instruction we get from Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Srila Rupa Goswami, Atyanta Durlava Karibara Dana. Bhakatera Saranagati, what is it? Bhakatera Prana, yeah. Atyanta Zullava Karibaradana, very difficult to achieve Krishna Prema. ಅತ್ಯಂತ ದುರ್ಲಭ ಕರಿಬಾರೆ ದಾನ ಭಕ್ತೇರ ಪ್ರಾಣ ಯಾ ಪ್ರೇಮ ಶರಣಾಗತಿ ಅತ್ಯಂತ ದುರ್ಲಭ ಪ್ರೇಮ ಕರಿಬಾರೆ ದಾನ ಸಿಕಾಯ ಶರಣಾಗತಿ ಭಕ್ತೇರ ಪ್ರಾಣ ಸೊ ಅತ್ಯಂತ ದುರ್ಲಭ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಟು ಕಮ್ ಟು ದ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಪ್ರೇಮ ಲವ್ ಆಫ್ ಗಾಡ್ ಬಟ್ ಶ್ರೀ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಮಹಾಪ್ರಭು ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಕಮ್ ಫ್ರೀಲಿ ಟು ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ಕರಿಬಾರೆ ದಾನ ಪ್ರೇಮ ಕರಿಬಾರೆ ದಾನ ಟು ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲವ್ ಸಿಕಾಯ ಶರಣಾಗತಿ ಹಿಮ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಬೈ ಹಿಮ್ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಡೌನ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಡಿವೋಟಿ ಟು ಟೀಚ್ ಅಸ್ ಹೌ ಟು ಸರೆಂಡರ್ ಸಿಕಾಯ ಶರಣಾಗತಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ಆಲ್ ದ ಡಿವೋಟೀಸ್ ದೋಸ್ ಹೂ ವಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ರಿಯಲಿ ಫಾಲೋ ಶ್ರೀ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಮಹಾಪ್ರಭು ದೇ ಸಿನ್ಸಿಯರ್ಲಿ ದೇ ಆರ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ಆರ್ ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್ ಸಿನ್ಸಿಯರ್ಲಿ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಫಾಲೋ ಹಿಸ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈನ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಸಿಕಾಯ ಶರಣಾಗತಿ ಭಕ್ತೇರ ಪ್ರಾಣ ದೇ ಗಿವ್ ದೇರ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಟು ಫಾಲೋ ದ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಶ್ರೀ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಮಹಾಪ್ರಭು ದ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಸರೆಂಡರ್ ಭಕ್ತಿ ವಿನೋದ್ ಠಾಕೂರ್ ಎಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಅಪ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಐ ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ಡ್ ಭಕ್ತಿ ವಿನೋದ್ ಠಾಕೂರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಅಪ್ ಜುಲೈ 9th ಇಸ್ ಭಕ್ತಿ ವಿನೋದ್ ಠಾಕೂರ್ ಡಿಸಪಿಯರೆನ್ಸ್ ಡೇ ಅಂಡ್ ಗದಾಧರ್ ಪಂಡಿತ್ ಡಿಸಪಿಯರೆನ್ಸ್ ಡೇ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಬೋತ್ ಆಫ್ ದಮ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಡೇ ಇಫ್ ಐ ನಾಟ್ ಮಿಸ್ಟೇಕನ್ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಡೇ ಭಕ್ತಿ ವಿನೋದ್ ಠಾಕೂರ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಒನ್ ವಿ ಸಿ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲಾರ್ಡ್ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ರಿಟನ್ ಈ ಸೆಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು ಕೆನಡಾ ಮೆಕ್ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಲೈಬ್ರರೀಸ್ ಪ್ರೋಪಾದ್ ಕೇಮ್ ಸಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಡಿವೋಟೀಸ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬುಕ್ ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಎನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಭಕ್ತಿ ವಿನೋದ್ ಠಾಕೂರ್ಸ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಇಮ್ಯಾಜಿನ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಲೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಒನ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಚೈತನ್ಯ ಚರಿತಾಮೃತ ಒನ್ ಕಾಪ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಈ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಕಾಪಿ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ವಾಸ್ ಸೋ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಸೊ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ವಾಸ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಬೈ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಎಂಟಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎಂಗೇಜ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಸೋ ಮನಿ ಅನ್ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಷನ್ ಸೊ ದ ಸರೆಂಡರ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸಿಕ್ಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಭಕ್ತಿ ವಿನೋದ್ ಠಾಕೂರ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೆನ್ಷನಿಂಗ್ ದೈನ್ಯ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯುಮಿಲಿಟಿ ಹ್ಯುಮಿಲಿಟಿ ಇಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಮಚ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ವೈ ವಿ ನಾಟ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಸರೆಂಡರ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ದೇರ್ ವಿ ಥಿಂಕ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ದ ಪ್ರೊಪ್ರೈಟರ್ ಸೊ ವಿ ಥಿಂಕ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ದ ಎಂಜಾಯರ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವೈ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ವರ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ ಅನ್ಲೆಸ್ ವಿ ಗಿವ್ ಅಪ್ ದೀಸ್ ಡಿಸೈರ್ ಟು ಎಂಜಾಯ್ ಸಪರೇಟ್ಲಿ ಅನ್ಲೆಸ್ ವಿ ಥಿಂಕ್ ದಟ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಅನ್ಲೆಸ್ ವಿ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರೊಪರೇಟರ್ ಆಫ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ಲೂಡಿಂಗ್ ಅವರ್ ಬಾಡಿ opulence or possessions or kids or family, then only there is a chance to surrender. Then only there is a chance to come to this Brahmi sthiti, Brahma bhuta stage. Then only we will be able to come to that love of God. Even a tinge of the desire is there, we will not be able to go. So as it is mentioned here, dainya, humility will not come. How will it come? Just like Prabhupada gives simple examples. Like we live in apartment. Most of us has experience of living in apartment. So what is the place? Apartment is a temporary place. But apartment has so many, means it has two bedrooms, three bedrooms, single bedroom, whatever. Different rooms and it has different place to keep your stuff, clothes and whatnot. Then you keep on piling up. Especially if you are there only 2-3 months, then you may not pile up so much. But more we become, more we stay for a year, 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, more we stay, more we are keep on piling up, even though it is a temporary place. Even though it is a temporary place, which means it doesn't belong to us, we are paying rent, we have to follow very much, especially in New Jersey, they are very strict. You can't put the clothes out in the balcony, you can't put anything, hardly even the plants, you can't put so many things, many apartments, as we have a lot of restrictions. In other places they may not be, but here, so we have to follow by, even after paying the rent, we still have to follow very strictly the rules and regulations, other than paying rent also. So, and then we are not able to understand that this body also is temporary. We are thinking this is permanent, just like the apartment is temporary. So, and then we are getting comfortable in staying in that apartment and getting adjusted. Getting more and more comfortable and piling up, accumulating things. And those apartment is like this temporary place of this body. And all these rooms and all these different, whatever, different locations you have within these rooms are like this mind, intelligence and senses. We are filling up, accumulating so many things. That's why we have to perform Gundicha Marjan. Not like, just like imagine when you are vacating after 10 years, 20 years apartment, same place you stayed. And then when you have to vacate, if you don't clean up regularly, and what happens? Not only the apartment, our teeth, our body, everything. Imagine what is there inside subtle body, which is carrying for many lifetimes. This gross body, this body, particular body only we received this life. Previously, again, gross body is gone. Again, this life we got a new gross body. But subtle body is the one which is carrying for many lifetimes. You can imagine how much accumulation is there for many lifetimes. How much stuff is there. Keep on piling up. Apartment, we are piling up this temporary body. With that subtle body, we are piling up mind, intelligence, senses. So, despite we have everything, many things we may have, still we are desiring something else. That means, what is that underlying factor? Nirmama is not there. We think that everything is mama, mine. And who is the proprietor? Proprietor is not Krishna. I am the proprietor. I am the enjoyer. So that is why we are keep on. There is no simplicity. And we'll see that in the example of these simple and great devotees. Whether we look at Bandhu Mohanty from Jajipur, from Jagannath Puri. Whether we look at Sal Beg, Muslim Yavana from Jagannath Puri. And we see Dasya Bawri, same. Very, very simple. Some are Sal Beg was the son of a king, Muslim king. This, obviously, Mohanty, Bandhu Mohanty is very poor. And then Dasya Bawri is also poor, but he is also working. So you take any example, so many wonderful devotees, but they have surrendered, they have simple devotion, so much devotion, intense devotion. They are developed by simple just because of their surrender with humility. That is the main common factor we look when we see the Dasya Bawri or the Sal Beg or the Bandhu Mohanty. All three of them has this quality of humility. Unless they have that humility, it is very difficult to surrender. So that's why it is very, very important fact. That means we don't have anything. There is nobody else to protect. Humility means we really don't possess anything. We don't have a really, we cannot sustain, we cannot maintain, we cannot protect ourselves. That is the idea we'll have. So I'm the lowest. I cannot really go on with my life without the protection of the Supreme Lord, without the help of the Supreme Lord. So everything belongs to the Supreme. That's why here. So starting is the dhainya. So same thing Rupa Goswami is mentioning, the six steps of surrender. When Krishna mentioned Sarvadharma Parichyadya, last point, that is important point. Whole Bhagavad Gita conclusion is two things. One is surrender, and the other is that how to surrender. Simply, and Krishna is giving that example also. Manmanava Mad Bhakto Madhya Jivam Namaskuru Mame Vaisya Satyante Pratijane Priyos. Two times he is mentioning, 9th and 18th chapter. So four things, offer obeisance to me, think of me, become my friend, worship me. So that these are the four things. The Rupa Goswami is mentioning what means surrender means. And same thing, Bhaktivinoda Thakur here it is mentioning in this Atyanta Durlabha, Karivare Dana, Prema Karivare Dana, Sikhaya Saranagati, Bhakatera Prana. So what that is? Dainya, Atma Nivedana, Dainya, Goptritta Varnam. Dainya, first, and Atma Nivedana and Goptritta Varnam. Dainya means humility, Atma Nivedana, self-surrender, and Goptritta Varnam. Means Krishna is going to maintain me. Nobody else can maintain me. Nor friend, nor family, nor somebody else, my manager, my boss, or somebody, no. Only Krishna can maintain us. That is the complete dependency. And then further, Krishna, Avasya Rakhibe Krishna Vishwasa Palam. That Krishna is going to protect me, Vishwasa Palam, strong faith. So maintain me, protect me, having the full self-surrender and humility, and then anukulya. What is it? Yeah, bhakti anukula matra karyera srikar. Only accept what is favorable, and then pratikula. Yeah, bhakti pratikula bhava vajjanangi ka, not vajra. Vajjanangi, vajja means opposite. Na angikar. We will not act, we will reject. Vajjam means reject. So, in a day when we have Vajram, we don't do things. So, that is a reverse, opposite. We reject unfavorable things. This is the surrender means. This is the first and foremost one must have. So, as we stay in apartment, we get comfortable. So, but if we understand that more we stay, more we are getting comfortable, more we accumulating. But more we keep it simple. So whether it's temporary place, apartment or a home. Home is also, we think, we do, as Prabhupada also gives, just like the, you know, the Arabians, you know, Saudis are thinking the oil belongs to us. We'll charge left and right. Now the prices are increased because of something. So it's like that. Everybody is thinking, this is mine, this is mine. But actually, nothing belongs to, when they are born, did they bring oil? No. Nothing belongs to anybody. Everything belongs to Krishna. So in that way, so this apart, just like the father, the apartment owner is giving that apartment. Same way, when we are giving child, father is, or mother is giving to the child. But child is thinking that it is not his property. He is thinking, so father has brought, father has given. So it is father's property. Same way, Krishna has given this body. Krishna has given this property. So we have to use it very carefully. We have to pay the rent. So body has been given, apartment you are paying. To the degree we pay, to that degree you get luxury apartment or ordinary apartment. All the same way, our body also, karanam, gunasanga, sadda, asad, jamma, yonish. Accordingly, we are receiving this body. Accordingly, we are, have this pious credits, what kind of job, what kind of everything. So, there is no by chance concept. So, everything is by the will of the providence. But how we use is very important. In this life, how we use the free will, whatever piety we got, whatever we have received, but how we use it. If we don't use it properly, then the next life is going to be even much more miserable. So that we have to be very careful. At least we have to understand this fact. So that's why it is very important. So Krishna is mentioning later on also to Arjuna. You have to give up this everything. So nirmama, nirasi means you are not the proprietor. Vihaya as sarvakaman. As the previous 70 verse also, the same thing is mentioning. You know, proprietor, you are not the proprietor. So, means you don't expect any results, you shouldn't be attached to results. Krishna is telling, nirasi nirmamo bhutva, sanyasya vikata jvara. Just act on my order. You don't need to know, okay, you don't need to know anything. Just do what I say, that's it. Surrender means, whatever Krishna is saying, whatever Guru is saying, whatever Shastra is saying through Guru, then just do that. You don't need to do separately anything. And the first and foremost point is the hearing. So the easiest thing is two things. We have to hear Krishna Katha and we have to hear, you have to chant the holy name of the Lord and hear. These two things are very important. Where it is mentioned, Gorangera Madhura Leela Thara Karna Praveshila Hrudaya Nirmala Bereta. Our heart will become cleansed by hearing. More and more we hear Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pastimes, end to end, from beginning to end, so much nectar. So much they are written, still it is not complete. The most authorized is Chaitanya Charitamrita, biggest book, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami Prabhupada has translated. Then you have Chaitanya Bhagavat, which Vrindavan Das Thakur, who is Vyasadeva of Krishna Leela. Vrindavan Das Thakur has written Chaitanya Bhagavat. These are the two biggest main books. But then there are so many versions because Murari, so many servants, so many associates are there. So they all have written their association, their dealings, their pastimes when they are there in the association of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Whether it's Murari Gupta Karacha, whether you have Jagannath Vallabh Nataka from Ramananda Rai, or talking about Chaitanya Charita Mahakavya, written by Kavi Karnapur, Sivananda Sena's son. So many are there. Gauranga Stava Prakash of Raghunath Das Goswami is there. And then you have Chaitanya Chandramruta, Chaitanya Chandramruta by Prabodhananda Saraswati. So like this, so many are there. And obviously Lochan Das Thakur has written Chaitanya Mangal. In the form of song, that's where this Jagannath, how Jagannath appeared, the Mahaprasad, that pastime is described in Lochan Das Thakur Chaitanya Mangal book. It is translated in English also, not a song, but as a actual text also. It is available in our gift shop, in our bookstore also. And like this, it is unending pastimes. So much rasa, you get more and more we hear. So that's why this, it is mentioned as, more we hear, with rapt attention, then we will be able to give up this lethargy and fight, take as my order as my life and soul and execute. Krishna is telling, then you will not, because you are thinking you are the proprietor, that's why you are telling, I don't want to fight because my family, my relatives will be gone. If I fight, there will be sinful activity, even so many reasons he is given. That means you think that this body belongs to you, you think that this whole thing belongs to you, you can decide on your own. So you are not thinking that everything belongs to the Supreme Lord, even the Krishna, Supreme Lord himself is personally there, but he is not considering. So obviously Arjuna is acting to teach us the lessons. So that's why these lessons are given. That's why even the lessons of Brahma and Shiva sometimes getting bewildered. Is because they are the controllers of the different modes. So that is it. It's just to teach us the lessons that even at the highest level also, unless we are surrendered and we are engaging pure devotion service. Mamchayo abhyabhicharena bhakti yogena sevate sagunan samatitta etansa. Samatitta etan means samyak etana. Samyak means all the senses. Samyak means completely. Mind, intelligence, ego, senses. Everything must be used in the service of the Lord. Pure devotion service. No other desire other than just pleasing the spiritual master and supreme Lord. That means you'll have everything. You can have everything. Home or apartment, whatever. Opulence, whatever, car. Everything you can have. But everything you think in terms of, but more and more we keep simple, it is better it is. Because in general, it is very difficult. More you accumulate things, more we pile up, more unending desires are unlimitedly going, then it is very difficult. It is very rarely you see. So that's why Krishna is mentioning before itself. Bhogaisara prasaktanam taya aparata chetasa samadav na vidiyate. One who is completely filled up with so much bhoga enjoyment, then for him there is no possibility to come to the samadhi, surrender. Come to the self-realization, it is very difficult. So that's why we have to understand this aspect of this, how otherwise just like the fish is in the ocean has so much food, fish can eat, it can live, it doesn't need anything external. But still, as soon as this fisherman puts something which fish likes, snake or whatever, they put the bait inside the water, that's it. And fish gets attracted and then eats and then it gets stuck. Obviously, life is taken away. So this is the way, same way we also, just like the fish is getting attracted, the five senses as we are discussing, in this way our senses, the network is there and then getting attracted. Moha jala smavrata. Same way, so we are getting also captivated by these. So that's why sometimes I mentioned when men come from office, work, come back to home, he's been caught by six wives. The six wives of these five senses, knowledge acquiring senses, and one is the sixth one is the mind. These six, all of them are captivating him and not able to relieve him. So, just like the living entity is put in the prison when he doesn't follow the state rules. So, then there is no way to come out unless he get reformed. So, then only he can be released. But for the living entity, one who is there in the material world, he cannot escape. The state for state department or whatever, government can, maybe you can escape, but the living entity cannot escape from this, the rules of Daivi Hesha Gunamai. Very difficult to escape from the material, from this, the material external energy of the Lord. Very difficult. Because all the senses, mind, intelligence is captivating the living entity. So here you go, here go ahead and enjoy, go here, get this, get that, so many. So whether it is, now it is so many advertisements, all these things are modernization is more and more, it's even to the extent it is mentioned in the ninth canto also that the senses are so strong. So where it is mentioned, Balavan Indriya Gramo Vidvisham Karshati. So strong, the senses are so strong, you shouldn't even sit closely, close to your sister or mother. Senses are so strong. Shastra is recommending that. You can imagine. So how much we are captivated our senses. Because of this life after life going on with the same mentality of attitude of false ego, that we are not depending on the Supreme Lord. That's why the first and foremost thing is we have to hear. Last week also we discussed that. Pravishta Kannarandrena Swanam Bhava Sarorham Dhrumati Samalam Krishna Selinam Yathasarat. It must enter through ear holes. That's why it is very important to hear. And the second one is the chanting the holy name of the Lord. And there is no other way. Shastra is clearly telling, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is telling, Nama Vinu Kalikale Nahi Aradana Nahi Aradharma Sarva Mantra Sara Nama Yehi Shastra Marma. The essence of all the, in Kali Yuga, there is no other. Nama Vinu Kalikale Nahi. There is no other thing other than chanting the Aradharma. There is no other Dharma. Sarva Mantra Sara. This is the essence of all the Sarva Shastra. Sarva Mantra. All the essence of all the mantras. And Yehito Shastra Marma. The essence of all the Shastras, the essence of all the names is chanting the holy name of the Lord. Especially Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. And how will you get out of the anarthas? By simply chanting the holy name of the Lord. Not only 16, but gradually we have to come. If you are not chanting, it's fine. First round, two round, six rounds, eight rounds, like that, we have to increase. But gradually, more we sincerely engage and then come. And then gradually we have to come to the point we are always chanting. By that, naturally we will be able to, all anarthas, everything, whatever is there in the heart. Mahaprabhu is telling this. I am not telling this. Mentioned, Nama Sankirtan Haite Sarva Anardhanas. Nama Sankirtan Haite Sarva Anardhanas. Sarva Subhodaya Krishna Pemer Ullas. So by chanting the holy name of the Lord, Krishna, one can be freed from all undesirable habits. Sarva anardhanas. Anardha nivruti is the biggest obstacle in our life. That's why we run around. The mind, senses, intelligence, everything is running around. We're changing different apartment, different homes, sometimes multiple, sometimes more. There is no end. Desire, there is no end. That's how it goes. Because once you give something to the child, what child will do? Child will keep on going from one to another. He wants to play with this, he wants to play with that. He will catch this, he doesn't know. Sometimes he will put a finger in the fan also, sometimes he will put finger in the fire also. And then he gets, obviously, he will feel the pain. Still he will do so many mistakes. But as a father is looking at it and then he tells. But he still, despite telling, he may do so many things. So, same as the Supreme Lord, a super soul is already indicating, but still we are the one running away, despite getting instructions through Guru, through Shastra, through super soul, through different difficulties, through different problems we face, but still we are not learning the lessons. We are still going through, we are still trying to enjoy day after day. So, that's why it is very important by taking Nirantara Nama Loilo, Prema, Krishna Prema. So by taking the chanting the holy name of the Lord, more we have to increase whatever we do. So then automatically it will become desireless. It will become desireless means it will be full of desiring to serve the Supreme Lord. So whether we are cooking, whether we are buying a car, everything we'll see that think about Krishna. Think about Krishna, as you can see, we'll come to pretty soon to the Dasya Bhavari story. Krishna is also giving the example of this, just like the lamp, the self-realized soul is controlled completely, desires are controlled, just like the rivers are entering the ocean before, or 69th verse, it is mentioned, or 70th verse. So, here also Krishna is mentioning another example of Yatha Dipo Nengate Nivatasto Nengate Sopama Smruta. Yogino yata chittasya yunjato yogam atmana yata dipo nimatasto means lamp. Whenever you have a lamp, so by the air, there is a fluctuation of air, then the lamp cannot stay. But as soon as the lamp can stay fixed, nimatasto, if it stays fixed, nengate sopama asputa. Just like that, this upama means example, like that, the yoga chittasya, one who is yukta, the yogi who is completely fixed up, his intelligence, his mind, is fully controlled, like that the lamp, when it is not affected by the wind, how fixed it is. Same way, living entity, if we can focus, if we can fix, use his senses in the service of the Supreme Lord. That means when the lamp, if you use the lamp within a lantern or within a closed, enclosed in something, it is being filtered, it is being protected, it is being shielded, then automatically, it even if it is wind is there, it can be, it won't go. The flame will not go. The fire will not go. So that means we have to be protected. We have to be associated. Sadhu Sangha is another important aspect, associating with devotees. More we have to associate with advanced devotees. We see throughout the Chaitanya Charitamrita, instruction after instruction, whether it's one of six Goswamis or whether it is a Kurma Brahman, whether it is Satyaraj Khan, again and again, Mahaprabhu is telling, here, chant the holy name of the Lord Nirantar, and also here Srimad Bhagavatam. Read Srimad Bhagavatam here, discuss, share with Krishna to others. Associate with those and discuss, it means associate, sadhu sangha, share with others, make others devotees and then be in that association, discuss, chant, sankirtan. This is the main point. More we associate with those who are advanced, those who have developed taste for chanting the holy name, those who have developed taste for hearing, taste for serving the Lord, serving the devotees. Love is the main important aspect in sadhu sangha. Where it is mentioned, what is it? Sadhu Sanghe Satovrutte. Sadhu Sanghe Satovrutte. What is that? I forget the line. It's where it is mentioned, advanced devotees. One who is associated with those who are advanced in these devotion service more and more. Associating, hearing from them, serving them. Then in this way, we will be able to advance more quickly and we will develop that love. We will develop the taste. So that is what is the main point here. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is teaching. That's why the Chaitanya Charitamrita is so sweet. Pastime of the instructions are very deep actually. It's unending pastimes. So throughout these different speakers, different acharyas, different whether it's Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami or Vrindavandas Thakur or this Kavi Karnapur or Raghunath Das Goswami or Prabodhanand Saraswati. So many are there, one after another. Bhaktivinoda Thakur also, Chaitanya Chandramrita, Shikshamrita, Bhaktivinoda Thakur has written. So like these, so many acharyas has written the pastimes of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Chaitanya Charita Mahakavya, Chaitanya Charita Mahakavya, that is also not a beautiful pastime. Some other time we'll discuss that. That is written by Kavi Karnapur. Jagannath Vallabh Natka is written by Ramanand Roy. And then there is a Prema Vivarta with Jagadananda Pandit is written. So all these are very, very beautiful pastimes of the Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And different, some are poetry, some are drama. So either way, passion or form, whatever passion or form, it is to really bring us to close to the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord Sri Krishna. So now coming to the example, we have to understand how to develop the devotion. Like we'll take the example of Dasya Bhavari. Most of you might have heard Bandhu Mohanty. We have played the drama also in Central New Jersey before, a couple of years before. So Dasya Bhavari, he was from a village called Bali in near Jagannath Puri, couple of miles away, very close to Jagannath Puri, from village called Bali. So his name is Bhavari, Bhavari Das. You know in Orissa, like our Ashesh Karana Prabhu also has Das. Many people from Orissa has Das. So from different, different groups. I think especially here, Das, Bhavari Das, Dasya Bhavari became later on. Das, Bhavari, originally from the lower caste, lower than the Savaras. Savaras means lower than Sudras and is even further lower. So basically outcast kind of. They will not allow him to enter into Jagannath Puri or anything. So, but he was not having kids. Him and his wife is married, and then what he used to do for work, he's poor, but he used to do cloth at home itself. They used to through threads and everything in old India. Even now, many like how we get the saris and the dhotis, all these things, somebody is doing it. So still, so the now modern, more and more modernization is happening. But in olden days, this is happened. This was the main business. So many people used to work and get the money, daily work. Same way here, the Bauri Das also from Bali village, Bali, used to work in that way every day and then get some money exchange that and to get his rice. So hardly they used to eat very simple. So rice and little sabji, so beans or whatever is there, saag. So that's how simple. But so he used to what he was not educated so much as because he is the lower caste. So he is somehow or the other, he was not educated, he didn't have kids. So, but he used to get attracted for hearing. Whenever Krishna Katha used to happen, Hari Katha used to happen, he used to go and hear, even though he is not understanding anything, or chanting the holy name of the Lord. Wherever Sankirtan is happening, wherever this holy name Katha is happening, Hari Katha is happening, he used to go there and he used to attend. But he was not, means he is not aware of the actual, he is not able to understand many of them. But still, he used to go and sit there and hear. And in that way, he developed attachment. Developed attachment. This is mentioned in by Parikshit Maharaj also. Bhagavan Visate. One who is attentively hearing, with faith, strong faith, and then is hearing with rapt attention and strong faith, then automatically, very easy, very soon, Lord will purify his heart. He will enter into his heart. He will give his darshan, voice. Just like here we see, Narada Muni has heard the voice, and Das Bauri also will see what happens. Then one day, all the villagers from that Bali, village Bali, they all gathered and they are discussing. Then Bauri Das also, so beautiful names. You see, Bandhu Mohanty. Who is the friend? Jagabandhu. He used to sing also. Used to think of Jagabandhu, who is Jagannath, Lord Jagannath. He is the friend of all the living entities in the universe. That's why he is Lord of the universe. So, Bandhu Mohanty. The names are also kept like that generally those days. Now they are using different names. You cannot even think of the Lord with the names. That's how the names are kept now. But those days it is clearly on that. You see, Das Bauri also, you can see Das means servant. Bauri means bhava, ecstatic symptoms, bhava towards the Supreme Lord. So in this way we can see the names also is very beautiful in thinking in relation with Krishna. So here as he heard everybody is going to Jagannath Puri, then he also had a desire. As he was hearing, even though he was not understanding many things, he was sitting and hearing. So you can see Krishna has purified Anandambudhi Vardhanam automatically, pleasure. Naturally, he has developed that pleasure in our senses, being getting pleasure of hearing and seeing the vision and everything. Nama Rupa Guna automatically has developed because of the association and his hearing. So that's why it's very important. And then he went along with them. So can I also come? And then he went along with them, the villagers. He went in Jagannath Puri and Jagannath Rath Yatra, especially. Then he was captivated by seeing. Chakkadola, Lord Jagannath Chakkadola, which means big eyes, sitting on Ratna Simhasan. He came out from Ratna Simhasan. Even on Snana Yatra day, also Lord Jagannath comes out from Ratna Simhasan. Then Snana Mandap is coming out and giving darshan. So beautiful. Even Salbeg also used to do. So because he cannot enter, he is the Muslim, he was also not able to go. Actually, that's another pastime. We'll maybe shorten it, but here. Das Bauri came and then he saw Lord Jagannath on Rath Yatra and Rath Yatra cart. Then he was completely captivated. Tears flowed down. Then he started praying. He's completely in humility. He started praying to Lord Jagannath. Oh Prabhu, you are so merciful. I am the most sinner. I am the most sinful person. So I don't have anything. Just please give me mukti. Please give me salvation. That's all. He didn't ask for anything. He was not educated. He was not. He's simple. He's very humble. So he can see, he felt himself, I am most sinful, most sinner. Please, oh Prabhu, please give me salvation. He saw his beautiful eyes, big eyes, red hue. So that means he is completely, that's why Lord Jagannath. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is showing his hands, that means surrender. His teaching, he came to Atyanta Durlava Karivar, Prema Karivar Dhanam. Shikaya Saranagati, Bhakatera Prana. So that's why we are, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying that. Because his teaching by his mudra, by his form, two hands raised up, which means surrender. Draupadi also did the same thing when she was completely not able to do anything, save herself. She had to raise up her hands and pray to Krishna. Then Krishna has come, Mukunda, Lord Mukunda. Here Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is teaching us that surrender with humility, very much. So I say, Lord Jagannath is trying to hug, he's opening his open hands, he's ready to embrace devotees, ready to distribute his prema. He is so much in separation of his devotees, separation from Srimati Radharani, and to distribute his prema. So he's, because otherwise, why is he called Patita Pavan? Lord Jagannath is thinking, whole year I am sitting on Ratha Simhasan, accepting this, accepting that, then how can I be called Patita Pavan unless I come out to deliver the living entities? So that's why Lord Jagannath is waiting for Ratha Yatra, waiting for Snana Yatra. Even Chandana Yatra also, all these festivals beautifully done in Jagannath Puri, as famous for even festivals also. Chandana Yatra happens 21 days. Lord Jagannath goes to Narendra Sarovar and takes his bath. Who goes? Lord Jagannath's Utsav deity, Madan Mohan, goes to Narendra Sarovar during that Chandana Yatra. 21 days outside, 21 days inside. 42 days Chandana Yatra happens in Lord Jagannath, in Jagannath Puri. Everything is so beautifully done in Jagannath Puri. So everything, Chandana Yatra, Snana Yatra, all these, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is giving darshan, and Lord Jagannath is giving his darshan. He wants to give his, as Patita Pavan is teaching us, he wants to show his mercy. So here Das Bhavari was so much attracted, captivated by seeing his big eyes and his with red hue, the blackish blackness is there in between. So he was so much attracted and captivated by the beauty of Lord Jagannath, and immediately fell down, offered, surrendered, is falling down again and again, offering, oh Prabhu, please deliver me. So simply offered, and then tears started falling down. So then he was so happy, so it was so enlivening. Then he went back to Jagannath, from Jagannath Puri, went back home. Then his wife, obviously when he came back, then she offered some food. So it was rice and some kind of beans. Somehow or the other, when she offered in a plate or something, then he saw the reflection of Lord Jagannath. When these two are combined, the rice and she put the beans on top of it, somehow or the other, so whether the plate, the reflection, he's seeing Lord Jagannath. When she offered, then he was not taking food. Then he was dancing. He was dancing. What has happened to my husband? After coming back from Jagannath Puri, he became mad or what? Some ghost or something has happened. Then she called all the villagers. This is what is happening. Then they could understand. Now you separate these two things. This curry, sabji, and this rice thing. You separate it out, two separate things. Then he was pacified. Then he took. So otherwise he was thinking, and then he was thinking, while taking also he was thinking, Jai Jagannath, he was thinking of Jagannath. And then from that day onwards he started, while weaving the cloth, whatever he was doing, then he was simply thinking of Lord Jagannath, same thing what he was observed at Ratha Yatra. He was simply having that mood, that absorption, that attraction to the beautiful form of Lord Jagannath. He was simply captivated, and he was the same thing he was thinking again and again. Throughout his work, throughout whatever, whole day he was thinking. And these days going by like this. Then one day, then because he was a cloth thing, weaving is his business. Then he went one day to the house of a Brahmana to basically to give this cloth. Then he saw a coconut tree, the first coconut. from the tree. And then he thought to me, oh, this coconut seems very nice, and this should be offered to Lord Jagannath. Immediately he was thinking in this way. Then also, in this way, then he offered, before that, while he was thinking in this way, then every day he was thinking of Lord Jagannath, and then Jai Jagannath, he was dancing, he was so much in meditation of Lord Jagannath. Then in one day night, in a dream, Lord Jagannath appeared, and then he was praying, and then Lord Jagannath told, okay, what do you want? Then he asked only, whenever I want to see you, please give me a darshan. And whenever I offer with my own hands, and you have to accept. From my, whatever I offer, you have to accept personally. It's not that like in a deity form, no. Personally, you have to come and accept whatever I offer. So these two things he asked. Then Lord said, all right, I am always ready to accept the offerings of my devotees. So then Lord disappeared. Then after this, then went to see this Brahmana. Then he saw the coconut. Then he asked Brahmana, can you give me the coconut? And he said, Brahmana also became, then he thought, oh, no, it is very expensive, so I cannot give you. Then he said, okay, then he understood, then let me, I will give you this cloth. The exchange of cloth, give me the coconut. Even though it's actually, that is not comparable. Cloth is more expensive, but still, Brahmana also became greedy. Then finally he didn't care. So even though he's very poor, he has to sell the cloth, then only he can get something. But he didn't care. He took the coconut because thinking of Lord Jagannath only. Wherever he is going, everywhere he is thinking of Lord Jagannath. He took the coconut, went home. Then he saw devotees going, some Brahmanas are going to Jagannath Puri. Then he told them, called them, can you please take this coconut? And then tell Lord Jagannath when you go there, Simhadwar, then you put in your hands and call to Lord Jagannath, ask him to accept this offering. Tell him that this your devotee from Bali, Das, Bauri Das, is coconut has given. Please accept this offering. He told me to offer. Please accept this. Then the Brahmana laughed. Who's going to accept? The person put in your hand. If he doesn't act, Lord doesn't accept, give me. Bring it back. Don't take it inside. Don't give it to Pandas. Don't put it in front of them. No. Clamp your own hands. You have to open your hand, put coconut like this, and then ask, pray to Lord Jagannath that this is given by Das Bauri. Then accept. So if he doesn't, then bring it back. Then they did exactly the same thing. Then all of a sudden, the hand appeared. Lord Jagannath's hand appeared, and then he took the coconut, and then he took it, accepted. Then everybody was surprised and shocked to see, because he was lower than a Sudra. And then how can this happen? Lord Jagannath is reciprocated. Then from that time, he's been called Bali Das. It means servant of the Lord. Bali Das means he is the whole village, Bali. He has been called as Bali Das. Then later on he is being called as Dasya Bauri. Dasya means servant. Das is originally his last name, Bauri, but Dasya, because Dasya means servant. In Dasya means always in humility he is serving. Dainyata, Dasya, in that way. He is serving, thinking of Lord Jagannath. So this has happened. Then when they returned, then obviously it told that Lord has accepted your coconut. And he was very much taking his blessing, taking his association and all those. He was very much, they were very much shocked and seeing the devotion, seeing the devotion of Dasya Bauri. Then he found some beautiful mangoes another time, after some time. And the days are going by, always thinking of Lord Jagannath. Every day he was thinking, whatever he is doing. Then he saw beautiful mangoes, nice color, golden color, ripened. So there is a pastime also. So Prabhupada has said, in Hawaii, so many mangoes are there, so many types of mangoes. In India also we have, but in Hawaii, sun is there for longer period. Then Prabhupada told him, where you go, sun is there most of the time. More time sun is there. So from the eastern side or some direction, Prabhupada told. In that direction, you get the mango from that. That will be the most. It should be golden yellow with the dots on it. So that's how mango. You can smell it. You can. So these mangoes are also like this. Beautiful color, beautiful smell, and very tasty. You know, as soon as then he saw this mango, then he purchased the whole thing from that mango seller. The whole basket of it, 50, 60, or 100, whatever is there, everything. Whether he can afford it or not, somehow when he is thinking, he is just thinking of Lord Jagannath. He is not thinking anything else. He is simply thinking, this is a beautiful thing, this must be offered to Lord. In this is the consciousness you can see, completely absorbed in that way. Then he immediately purchased. Then this time he only went. It's been a long time, so let me go. And then he went there. Then Panda saw these beautiful mangoes. So please give it to us. Give it to us. We'll offer. We'll offer inside. Then Panda stole. Then Das said, no. I'm not giving it to anybody. Lord has to take from here. If not, I'll take it back. I'm not going to give it to anybody. That's them. They are laughing and they are arguing with him and whatnot. So many. But still he didn't budge. He just standing there at Simhadwar outside Lord Jagannath's temple. He sat with his mangoes, that whole basket on the top, and then he's praying, Lord Jagannath is active. And suddenly the hand of Lord Jagannath appeared, and then one by one mango disappeared, then no mangoes left. Then they were shocked. Then they went back, ran back to the Lord Jagannath's Ratna Simhasan, and then they saw the seeds. Then they could understand, this is not ordinary devotee. So this is not an ordinary person. So much intense devotion. Then they could understand. Then they published the article. Then they added him. Because Lord Jagannath has so many wonderful devotees. So many like this. Intense devotion these devotees had. And Lord Jagannath is affectionately reciprocated with them. So many of them like this. So he was added into that list of close associates of Lord Jagannath basically. So in this way it's been Dasya Bhauri. So so much sincere and sincerely always in humility is begging, and Lord is whatever he is told in the dream that I will accept. He has asked for whenever I offer something you have to accept from my own hands or whoever, I might tell somebody's hands, but you have to accept, not as a in front of you, but whatever he's thinking to offer, then you have to accept like that. Otherwise, yeah, I will bring it back. And whenever I want to take your darshan, you have to show it to me. In this way, Dasya Bhauri became very famous. But he was not so much, he was thinking I'm a great devotee, or even somebody says, then he was not feeling like that. He was thinking, still thinking as the humble, lowest, most sinful. So in that way, he was thinking. He was naturally simple and simple at heart. So, he's completely thinking of Lord Jagannath. He was not thinking of who said what. Even somebody laughs, even somebody criticizes, somebody says you are mad, you have gone mad. So, he was not thinking of anything. Because his goal is not of any of this who said what. He's thinking, my goal is to serve the Lord Jagannath. What can I offer? What can I cook? What can I bring? When can I see Lord Jagannath? And this is the mood constantly he was thinking in this way. And then Sal Beg also, one of the Muslim king, he was fighting, and then he saw some of the ladies taking a bath in the river. Then he saw the one of the girl. Then everybody ran, but this about to get married Brahmani, daughter of a Brahmana. Then this king, Muslim king, married her later on, and then so many children, four or so, they all were somehow died at early age. Then the last one was there. Then his son, with this Muslim son Beg, I forget his name. Then he named his son as Sal Beg. Then he also went one time to fight with somebody, along with his father. Then his father, they both were injured, especially Sal Beg was injured like anything. So then his mother told, you have to pray sincerely to Nandalal, Krishna, Shamsundar Krishna Vrindavan. You have to pray to Krishna, then he will relieve everything, all the pains, whatever. He will make your body everything nice, bring it to the original thing. So only he can do. Sincerely pray. So then he was praying and praying. He didn't know anything. He just asked his mother, whatever mother said, because obviously daughter of a Brahmana, then she knows what is the best thing, how to worship, whom to worship. So then accordingly mother's instruction he followed. Then simply thinking every day, worshipping the Lord, praying to the Lord sincerely. Then Lord was very pleased. And then Lord appeared and then he gave some kind of a ointment, some kind of a powder, like a vibhuti. Then he said, apply this throughout your body, immediately everything will go and your body will be nice and strong. Then he came out from the dream and then immediately applied whole body. Then his body became strong. Then from that time, then he shared with his mother. Then immediately, I want to go and take the darshan of the Lord. So immediately want to go because Lord has cured and Lord disappeared. Then I have to see, I want to visit Vrindavan. Then Vrindavan is very far from where Jagannath Puri is. This village also close by to Jagannath Puri, some miles from Jagannath. Then he went to Vrindavan so far. Then Vrindavan, he was there quite some time, he was very happy. Then somebody told him, informed him that because he was from the Jagannath Puri area, then he told, you visit Lord Jagannath. Lord Jagannath is very merciful. He's non-different. He is Krishna himself. So then he was thinking how to go, because he is in Vrindavan. From Vrindavan, it's very far to come. And then he was thinking Radhayatra is about to start. So only few days left. Then to come by walk, it takes many days. So it's a very tight timeline. Then he was praying sincerely to the Lord that until I come, please don't start your Radha Yatra. So don't start Radha Yatra. So in this way, he was thinking, he was praying and meditating and coming down walking from Vrindavan, offering obeisances, Dandavat. He was not even coming by regular walk. Dandavat, like many do Govardhan Parikrama by Dandavat in Vrindavan. So he was coming like that, so far. Then in this way he was thinking and praying to the Lord Jagannath. Then king started using the elephants and horses. Lord Jagannath didn't even move. He tried his best. Then he sat down and praying, what did I do? Did we do any offenses? Why, Lord Jagannath, you don't want to move? So he said, but nothing has happened. Then when the Salbeg appeared there, Salbeg came finally one day. Then he came there. Then as soon as he pulled the Rath, then immediately Rathayatra Rath started. Lord Jagannath showed his mercy. So then king could understand he is not an ordinary person. Before that, obviously his mother passed away. Yeah. Before that event, he was thinking of Vrindavan and event also Jagannath Puri event before once. He visited, he took a darshan of Lord Jagannath. He was so happy, so blissful. Then he was praying to the Lord Jagannath. Then he went to Vrindavan. Then when he came back, then he heard. I think he didn't even come back. He heard that his mother passed away. Before that, his father passed away. Then his mother also passed away. Then he heard. Then he thought. Then somebody told you should go and see Lord Jagannath. Radha Yatra is starting. Then he has the intense desire to see Lord Jagannath Radha Yatra, attend Radha Yatra. So in this way, Salbeg also became famous. So you know, now this everybody knows in Jagannath Puri area all these great devotees. So by simple, all of them has a very simple devotion. It's simple at heart, constantly thinking of the Lord. So for us, that means we have to associate with devotees. We have to hear and we have to develop this humility. I think the Lord is the only protector, maintainer who can save. And then try to worship the Lord at home. And whenever we go and buy things, obviously we cannot become renounced completely. That means externally we cannot become renounced. That I don't want to buy home, or I don't want to buy stay in place. I'll just go and renounce, like Arjuna is telling. I'll renounce everything and go to forest. No, we cannot become like that. So it is more of internal detachment. So it is not external. Internally we have to become. That means we should try to be simple as much as possible. Whatever is needed, whatever is big things, wants are there. So we should try to minimize as much as possible. Sometimes it's not possible because we are in the with the family. Sometimes different needs are there, different wants are there also. Sometimes we may have to satisfy what can be done. But internally, our mood, our desire should be keep it simple, at least in the heart, and try to sincerely offer everything wherever, whatever we are buying, try to think that this is Lord's property. Use it very carefully and teach the same thing to kids. Everything must be very sincerely, seriously, must be used in the service of the Lord. Then it will be helpful. Otherwise, everything will create a bondage. Whether it's a home or a car or a cell phone, everything. You name it, even a small thing. Even a small thing, small attachment we have, we cannot go back. There is no possibility of going back to original place, going back to Vaikuntha Loka, going back to Godhead. It's very difficult. So not even a tinge should be there. So that's why this is all practice. Anta kale cha mamev smaran mukva kalevaram yaprayasamudbhavam yadina. In order for that to happen, so it must be, there must be a practice. So that's why Gaurange Sanghi Gana Nityakari Mani. So that's why we have to associate with Gauranga Sanghigana. We have to associate with Gaura Bhaktas more and more and hear, chant, dance, feast. In this way, then we can develop easily this attitude of humility, attitude to serve, attitude to develop love for devotees, spiritual master, and Supreme Lord. We don't develop love for devotees, then no possibility to develop love for the Lord. So we are seeing this. That means that is in the Kanishtha Adhikari stage. Rupa Goswami explains. Kanishtha Adhikari means he is thinking only ring the bell in front of the Lord, but he doesn't care about the devotees. He's seeing different. Gradually, we will come to that level of understanding. Initially, it may not be, but gradually, as we progress, we will understand that. We'll open up because confidentially, we must discuss. We have to share. We have to have a spiritual master. We have to have also. Associated with those advanced devotees, we have to share, otherwise, there is no possibility. How will we progress? How will we understand where we are, what difficulties we have, what situation we are going through, how we can go from next stage? Just like the manager has in office, also in IT world, even in business world, they discuss with their managers, so their promotion, their bonus, are their work schedule, what you are working on, what is happening, what are you able to do, what you are not able to do, what is your strength, what is your weakness. If this is happening in IT job, this is happening in business, then what do you think that, how do we think that we shouldn't be discussing, we shouldn't discuss, we don't need anybody else, we can go on with the life. Why do we think like that? So we have to think that the spiritual life is actually more serious than our material life, whatever we are to sustain our body only, and whatever extended body family needs. So we shouldn't neglect this primary duty of the using and serving the Supreme Lord. This is very important. That's why we need Siksha Guru. Other than Diksha Guru, we need Siksha Guru. We need to try to understand what's happening with us, otherwise it's very difficult. So that is the main point. We can see we are not at the expert like Dasya Bhauri or Bandhu Mohanty or the Sal Beg. They are able to see the Lord directly and they are able to get to that level, obviously in the association. Initially they did, either it's mother or the devotees, they have heard the holy name, they heard the Harikatha, some of they developed attraction, and then gradually the intensity increased, and then it happened. But we are not at that level. Obviously, previous Sukriti also will be there. So some of these, like we know in some of this Krishna Leela pastime, Gaur Leela pastime, some of these are there explicitly mentioned, like who was there, who was the Narada Muni in previous life, who was this Ajamil in the previous life, like this Prahlad Maharaj, what he did in the previous life, all these were mentioned. But some of these, not each and every devotee, we will not know what they were. But it is certain that previous life, they have also done some Krishna conscious activity. Otherwise, it is not possible. It is not possible. for them to continue. So devotion service is a continuous from the last life. So that's why it is very important to have. So Siksha Guru, it is important to discuss confidentially and try to see, introspect, as we discussed previous class also. Pratiksha and Pariksha and Samiksha. These three things must be there in life. It is there in our job, in our business, everywhere it is there. Even our home, you know, housewives also, everybody has doing this. We are waiting because when I'm going to get a new home, and I'm going to get a new car, or when I'm going to, my son is going to college, whatever. These things are happening. We are waiting. Pratiksha, Pariksha, tests are also there. Whatever we are going through. Samiksha, introspection is also there. How come I tried, I made this decision, but it didn't go through properly. Where did I go wrong? This is going on, but this is a material sense. But this must go on for the spiritual sense, where we are lacking, where we are going, what is our end goal, what is a short-term goal this year, this 6 months. So where? So this must be done. But we are so busy and caught up with our work, with our maintaining ourselves. So that is where the problem is. Mind, senses, intelligence, everything is filled up. Where is the chance? So we don't know when we will be kicked out from this place, when we will be kicked out from the material world. From this, means kicked out from the apartment. We don't know. Means landowner can say that he cannot stay anymore. So he doesn't. If we are not following rules, then obviously same way. So don't think that we will be in New Jersey. Sometimes we don't know if we are not executing devotion properly, or we create offenses. We are criticizing devotees. Lord can take us away. We may not be in New Jersey, we may be somewhere else. So that also can happen also. So don't take anything for granted. That for sure must be there in our consciousness. If we take it for granted that I'll be there, so I'll slowly improve, slowly will increase devotion service. That slowly, slowly when it will come, when the intensity will increase, we don't know, and the next life will also come. So that's a we have to use it very efficiently. Things are there, 24 hours is not enough otherwise. So, but priority is very important. Whether it's Salbeg or Dasya Bhauri or Bandhu Mohanty or any devotees, whatever Leela, Puri Leela, Mathura Leela, Navadvip Leela. So, in all the wonderful devotees, great devotees, exalted devotees, all the pastime we can see. But so it's the intensity must be increased. Without intensity, nothing. If you smoke is coming, unless intensity of fire doesn't increase, then how ghee will melt, how your sacrifice will go on? It cannot go on. So same way, unless our intensity increases, then where will the, all the smoke of dirtiness, all the so much garbage and accumulation of sinful activity and so much is there in all the places. Within our body, in all the apartments. When we clean up, we know, oh, I had to move from this apartment, I had to buy a home. So much I accumulated. Then we'll know, oh, I brought this 10 years ago, and let me sell this, or let me throw this. Then we'll think about, don't think at last minute. Anta kalecha maameva, you cannot think. These things, yes, what we have to throw, we can think in the apartment. But at that time, it's too late while leaving this body. We don't even know when we'll leave also. So that's why we should use, utilize carefully and understand these lessons. Then only we can come to this. Eshi Brahmi Stita Prapti Naina Prapti Mimoti Anta Kale Stitvas Anta Kale Brahma Nirvana Muchati. Then only we can come to Brahma Nirvana. It takes only 1 minute. Surrender, it takes only 1 minute. Fully surrender. But problem is none of these are cooperating. Neither our senses cooperating, nor our mind, nor our intelligence. Because they have their different desire, different, they are pulling in different directions. So that's why more and more we take it seriously. Praying also, other than our endeavors, physical endeavors, trying to do service, trying to chant, trying to hear, trying to read, all this. We have to allocate time. If you don't allocate, nothing is going to happen. Believe me. If you don't allocate, if you don't plan, nothing is going to happen. Nothing is going to change. Nothing is going to change. If you allocate time, if you plan, then something may happen. If you seriously plan, then something more may happen. So more and more it becomes serious and planning, then in the execution some percentage will happen. If that planning itself is not there, then there cannot be execution. So that's why. So this is what the lesson. To come to Brahmi Sthiti, Brahman alone, Brahma Bhuta stage, liberated stage, then this is what we have to do. So I'll stop here. Thank you very much for patiently listening. Gandhara Srimad Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita ki jaya, Shri Prabhupada ki jaya, Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ki jaya, Dasya Bhavri ki jaya. Jai Jagannath.